Welcome to my participation as the first author within the work that I will summarize, Hyperconnected Youth, the Standpoint of Families Facing Their Children's Virtual Interaction. This work is about qualitative methodology located within the state-level research project called The Hyperconnected Identity of Youth and Their Perception of Time and Digital Leisure, Connected, from Universidad de Salamanca, a project that deals with the study of the digital identity of young people between 12 and 18 years old. This paper is part of the Connected project and it focuses on the position that families have in relation with their children's digital interaction and how they influence in the development of their digital identity. In order to understand this work, a study of the question composed of three blocks was posed. First one, referred to social context, the pedagogical one, and finally the family context. On the first place, the social context, this point shows how in recent years there has been an uneven on human and social change in all of dimensions, caused by new technologies that have ended up transforming the personal self-construction of human beings. Since the study focuses on families' understanding regarding the hyperconnectivity of the children, we were interested in dealing with the pedagogical context to understand how new technologies mediatize young people. Being born and growing up in this digital society generates a certain dependency and may affect the way of thinking and acting compared with their parents, generating new ways of thinking, conceiving space and time, and other issues that should be studied from pedagogy and educational specific perspectives. And if we talk about education, we cannot forget one of the most important socio-educational agents among young people, the parents. They must provide tools through education, so in that virtual environment in which their children move, they don't have many risks in the years. Therefore, we take the family as an educational agent and the technological society in which the children develop to build our objective of the study, set as an objective that aims to know which concerns families regarding the construction of their children's digital identity and the actions they take. To do so, we focus on other specific objectives as they are to analyze the risks that families perceive within hyperconnectivity of their children, to know the perception about the degree of maturity of the children regarding critical thinking, as well as analyzing different types of parental control within hyperconnectivity. To achieve these objectives, we ran a qualitative methodology what a sample made up of families with children between 12 and 18 years old, 33 participants in total, 15 men and 15 women, whose children study in secondary schools in the community of Castilla y León. With this sample, information was obtained through the technique of discussion, groups and in-depth interviews, developed by the GPEP research group. The results of the study showed, in relation to the first objective, how the risks of addition dependence on new technologies become the main risks. Secondly, the loss of traditional values such as respect, attention and humility among others. Meeting strangers, bad influence and harassment situation are the other risks that parents highlight within the hyperconnectivity of their children. With regard to the second specific objective, parents highlight in their speeches the concept of information, mentioning the infinite number of documents of the internet as well as the lack of veracity in much of this content. In addition, they mention a lack of training in their children when it comes to discriminating between true and false information, which is why they point their children's critical thinking as being underdeveloped. For the third specific objective, the removal of the device, either by rules or by punishment for certain actions, appears with great importance as the main parental control. Sitting times for mobile phone use as response for lack of self-control by young people, either by allowing them to use their mobile phones at the weekend or only at certain times of the day. In conclusion, based on our results on the other research, we can say that the main risk for young people on the net tend to be those relating to addiction to technology, loss of values and harassment among other negative use. We also affirm a critical thinking that isn't very developed. They spend little time reading and comparing, but make a superficial reading. Also, parental control tends to be proactive, by monitoring time or removing to mobile phone through rules. Also, our conclusions cannot be extrapolated to the rest of the families due to the limitation of the numbers of participants in the study. We have been able to see how the results obtained are related to different investigations, so we are not talking about specific ideas or isolated conclusions. We can conclude that our study has allowed us to understand how families stand themselves regarding to their children's hyperconnectivity, and how parents can influence the construction of their children's digital identity.